Without any need of any additional software. So first you go to your browser, then you have to search for Google Scholar. Once you select the Google Scholar, you need to log in to your Google account. If you don't have any Google Scholar account, you need to create one. So in here, I will just look for my Google Scholar account. Now, after I searched my Google Scholar account, I can just write the name of the papers that I need to look for. In here, the title for my search would be Polymers Review. And once I click search, it will give me different type of papers that wrote about this subject. I could see that there is two commas. If I click these two commas, I could see that there are different types of citation style. I will pick the Harvard one. I will control C to select my option and copy it. Then I will go to my file. I will write down the word or the part in the thesis I want to write. So in here I will just write polymer. Now I will go to the end of the paragraph I have written or the title I want to just put the cite as a citation. So in here I will just write down my reference at the end of my title, and in here I could see that there in the new office I have here the references icon. Once I click it, I can search here the style that I want. Usual for the style we use in science is the Harvard. Then I will go to the reference, I will insert citation, add new source. Now I will control V to paste all the information I got from before. I have to click here the journal article. Once I click the journal article, because this is a journal article, if I had a book, I would have selected the book or the book section. But in section in here, I have the journal articles. This is why I choose this option. Now I will control X the page numbers, and I will go to the position where I have the pages. Then I will control X the volume. I just need to delete this part. And here is my journal title. So now I will control X again to put the journal name in that position. And I have here the title of the paper and in here the author. So until this word, I have the title of the paper. I will just paste it in that position, and the year is 2015. I will control X, then I will paste it here. You could see that the problem with that, it's a little bit manual, so you have to write down all icons, but it's still for free. Now if you clicked OK, so you could see that in here it added the author and the year according to the Harvard style. Now I will go to a new line because I need the full reference at the end of my paper, and I will go to the bibliography option, and I will select here. I have the bibliography if it is a thesis, but if it is a paper, I will just use the references. Once I click the references, it will show me here the reference I used in my paper. Now, if I have another reference, so I will go here to other option, and if I just, I will control C this sentence. So I'm copying this sentence, I will just paste it in here, and I need the another reference in that position, which was a reference number 2. Now I will go to the Google Scholar. Again, I will select these two commas, and I will go to the Harvard, and I copy the style as well. Once I click OK, it will put the reference at this position. If I updated my bibliography in here, I will click update. It will update and will put the references according to Harvard. It should be alphabetic order. So in here, the L before the O. Now, if I need to move this, move Leo, this reference instead to that position. So I can just select it and move it to that position. Once I click, I select it, it will update itself by removing the reference at the beginning of my section. So, and if I need to return, put it back, so in here I will just select it and put it back at the end of my section. And all I need when I make the changes, I have to update before I close my document. I have to update citation and the bibliography to make sure that the references are in the right orders. By that, we came to the end of our video. Thank you and goodbye.